lights are shining bright as always downtown on the road. I have friends that come from out of town asking me to go. They say there's so much going on. Why don't you come along and show us around? I tell them Karen's not feeling well, so I probably shouldn't go out. Besides, I've got a fix-it list of things I need to do around the house. Then I hang up the phone, turn the radio back on, and sit back down. I know my boy ain't here, but he ain't gone. In the mornings I wake up, give her a kiss, head to the kitchen. Pour a cup and wake me up and try to rouse up some ambition. Go outside, sit by myself, but I ain't home. I've got the fire. I've been pushed and shoved, but never ever really knocked down. Between Mom and Dad, Uncle Sam and friends, I somehow always pulled out. But the pain of this was more than I'd ever felt before. Yeah, I was broke. I cried and cried and cried until I passed out on the floor. Then I prayed and prayed and prayed till I thought I couldn't pray anymore. Then minute by minute, day by day, my God, he gave me hope. I know my boy ain't here, but he ain't gone. In the mornings I wake up, give her a kiss, head to
First, let me begin by saying thank you on behalf of the family for being here today. Thank you for your support. I can't even imagine. I can't. I want to have a word of prayer, and then I want to share a few things with you. And let's pray. We need you, Lord. This family needs you. We never know what tomorrow holds. But Lord, help us to remember who holds tomorrow. Lord, thank you. Thank you for loving us in spite of our sin. Now bless this family, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. I know you all knew Matt. I want to tell you a few things about myself, and then I want to share with you something that Matt meant to me. For those that might not know, I spent 2 tours of duty in Vietnam in the United States Marine Corps. When I came back to this country, I thought I could drink everything Johnny Walker made. I stayed drunk. Rear-ended a policeman at a traffic light in Jacksonville, Florida, and wound up in jail. I'm telling you that because I have no right to point my finger at anyone. No right whatsoever. For the Bible says we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Every single one of us. It doesn't matter how good I think I am. It doesn't matter how many sermons I've preached or how many Sunday school classes I've taught. It doesn't matter how many times I've gone to church or how much money I've given. That will not get me into heaven. The only thing that will get me into heaven is the blood of Jesus Christ. And Christ did not die for good people, okay? He died for bad people, and I is one. Matt was an encourager to me. You don't know that, but he was. When I pastored in Alma, Georgia, Matt would go up with me, go to the services, even spoke there one Sunday. When I resigned and my family couldn't be with me, Matt went. He went to encourage me, and he did. The last time I talked with Matt was some months ago, and he called me, asked me if I would baptize him. I said, Matt, sure. Let's get together and let's talk and then we'll set it up. He didn't call me back. And I regret that I didn't continue to try to reach out to him. Psalm 91 says, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. His truth. His truth. Not what I think. What he says. In Isaiah 25:8 it says, He will swallow up death in victory, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from off all faces. I don't know what you think. I personally believe that Matt is with the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe that. I really do. He's no longer suffering. He's no longer fighting demons. Maybe you've never fought them. I have. Psalm 56, verse 8 says, You have stored my tears in your bottle and counted each one of them. Can you imagine? We don't shed a tear that God doesn't count and store up. I'm going to tell you honestly, I want to be with Jesus. I want to fall down at His feet and thank Him for what He's done for me. He delivered me. He saved me. He saved Matt. Matt couldn't beat the demon. God did. God took him home, Diane. I know that probably doesn't comfort you a lot. I know you'd rather have him here. And I understand that. Some months ago, and I don't know if I should tell you this or not, but my son, who lives out west, had a drug problem, and he overdosed on crystal meth. Wound up in the hospital. I flew out. My wife had his son here in Georgia, and so she didn't go with me right then, and I spent a week beside his bed at the hospital. And I know what it was like when the doctor would come in and say, "Mr. Johnson, I'm sorry, but he's not going to make it." His kidneys had failed, liver shut down, had strokes. They did dialysis twice a week. And I sat there. He got a little better, and the doctor came in and said he might survive, but he will be on dialysis the rest of his life. No. He survived. He's not on dialysis. His mind is not as clear as it once was, but I thank God that we still have him. I can't even imagine Kenny and Diane. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but now it shall not come nigh to thee. We will never be able to fall away from God, because he will not let us go. He holds us, the Bible says, in the palm of his hand. I can't get out of that. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 12, it says, "For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then shall I know fully, even as I have been fully known." Matt knows now. Just as God knew Matt, Matt knows God. I believe that with all of my heart. I really do. And the reason I know that and believe it is because, as I've said, we're not converted and saved because of our goodness. It's not what I do or what I don't do that gets me into heaven. It's what he did at Calvary's cross. And I know, Diane, your heart's broken. And yesterday I was thinking about what the mother of Jesus must have felt like when she watched her son crucified. Not for anything he did wrong, but for our sin. How difficult it must have been for her. We will know as we are known. "Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling." Matt no longer has to worry about sickness or disease or heartache or brokenness or separation or rejection. Some of us may not have understood Matt, and we pushed him away. Let's remember, never push anyone away. Never, never. Because you may be the one that they need to help them overcome their struggles. Love people. Love them. "I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Forever with my mouth will I make known thy faithfulness to all generations." Could Matt sing? Probably could. Well, I'm not going to try to sing, but it says we will sing to the Lord. Can you imagine being in the presence of God Almighty and singing to the glory of God? And it no longer being about us. I'm afraid we live in a comfortable world. We wear nice clothes, drive nice cars, eat good food, live in nice houses. And we don't think about people in other places. Matt had a compassionate heart, whether you know that or not. He thought about other people. He thought about people who hurt. Oh, and by the way, he liked dogs. And the Bible says a good man takes care of his animals. Yes, I'm thankful to God that I am not going to be judged by my sin, but only by the blood of Christ. For without Christ, I am nothing. And that's the truth. I have no right to point my finger at anyone. None. None. For I don't believe there's anyone that could have been any worse than me. And the heavens shall praise thy wonders, O Lord, thy faithfulness also in the congregation of the saints. You know, saints here are not perfect people. Again, the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That idea, and I've shared this with you before, some of you, of coming short of the glory of God is the idea, actually in the original language, it's a archer's word for shooting an arrow and missing the target. We've all missed the target. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the wages of sin is death. Mark this down. If Jesus doesn't come back today, one day you will die. It's coming. I told my wife the other day, the average life expectancy of a white male in the United States is 76 years and 2 months. I told her I had one more month. I will die. And the only hope I have is Jesus Christ. I believe Matt knew him. I believe that with all of my heart. In traveling with him to Alma, in talking with him, in sitting with him, in listening to him speak at the church. Yeah. So, be an encourager. Think about those who are hurting and broken, who are suffering, who are struggling. Pray for them, encourage them, do what you can to help them. Matt did what he could to help me. And I'll always thank God for that. Let's pray. Father, once again, I just want to thank you that you love us in spite of our sin. You said the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We don't earn it, it's a gift. And we thank you for it. Lord, I want to thank you for the life of Matt Ellis. Lord, I know it wasn't perfect. I know he struggled. I know that. But I know what he did for me in encouraging me, trying to help me. I pray you bless all who are here, and especially the family. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sun, you work on earth is done.
Some